first step when looking at water quality is to measure what we have. A very simple and effective way to do it in the field is use water test strips. Put them in the water, pull them out. 15 seconds later, it gives you a reading. We just have a sample here. We've got some rainwater on this side. We've got some hard water. On this side, we just grab our little strips out. So we just dip our strip in the water, let it soak in for a few seconds, bring it out, and you just got to give it about 15 seconds so we can see the colours come up. So these pools test strips are really good at looking at total hardness. So you can see the rainwater there was very low here, and then you match up the hard water on the right, you see it comes in about 1,000 parts per million. Obviously we don't have chlorine in the rainwater, so it's very low. Another parameter we're looking for here is the pH. Both of these are quite low. The pH is about 6. So now we just have two jars of fresh rainwater. The pH was about, you know, low 6s. Now we're going to put some collide 700 in one jar to bring the pH down. So this is what we might do for peroxide dimethylate. So this was our rainwater that had a pH of low 6s. And then where we had the collide 700, it is yellower in colour, so it's off the chart, which is one of the limitations with using these pool strips is, you know, it's not 100% accurate. So this is a very good first step for testing your water, but we're missing salinity and bicarbonate levels. So the next step from here would be sending our water off to a lab to get properly tested for spray water quality. Another thing to keep in mind when considering water quality is the seasons and dry season. So the quality will vary in bores, you know, in the drought through to wet season. So it's a good idea to test regularly just to keep an eye on that spray water quality.